going to learn about the unicellular organism and multicellular. See, living things are made up of small unit called cells. All the actions and processes in bodies of living things are brought about with the help of microscopic cells. Our cells we cannot see, but you can see with the help of microscope. Okay. See, there is a picture given about the amoeba and paramecium. Why it is given? Some living things are made up of single cell. That means if some living things is made up of only with the single cell, it is called the unicellular. And example is the amoeba. All of you know amoeba? It doesn't have any fixed structure. It is like an it is called amoeba. On other hand, the living thing that made up of many cells are called multicellular organism. The amoeba and some other microorganisms are unicellular, while man, cow, mouse, cockroach, elephant, banyan tree, the onion plant are multicellular organism. We are the multicellular organism. In our body, many cells are there. All the characteristics of living things are seen every cell of living thing, whether it unicellular or multicellular. Cellular structure is the main characteristic of living thing, even though the number of cells may vary. See, all have the different cells, but plant also have the cells. They also form the cells in their structure in their body. So, the cellular structure is also one of the main characteristic of the living thing. See the page number 15. Institutes at work. The institutes at work for the survey and conservation of various plants and animals in different parts of India are the Botanical Survey of India and the Zoological Survey of India respectively. In case you find unfamiliar plant or animal in your surrounding, you can communicate with this institute to obtain more information about it. That means whenever you are think about which plant, if you are interested for the plants and you want any information, then you can contact with the Botanical Survey of India for the plant. And for the animal, you can contact with Zoological Survey of India. They can give you, these are the institute, they can give all the information about plants and animals. See, there is a useful living thing and harmful living things are given. Some plants are used for household as industrial purpose. For example, fenugreek, potatoes, okra, banana, apple, these all things we are going to eat as we are taking enjoy while the eating this. Mainly we are used as the vegetable, potato we use as the vegetable. And some plants like the heda, belda, asparagus are used as the medicine. Animals are also useful to us, like the dog, cats, cows. As the domestic animals, they are very useful. Dogs useful for the protection of the house. Buffaloes, cows, they are useful for the farming, for the agriculture. Fish, sheep, fowl are also used as they are also the fish we are eating. Not all eating, but some of the persons are eating as the food. So these are the useful living things. But what about the harmful living things? Some animals and plants around us are harmful to us. Like the sea, mosquitoes and kites spread the diseases, right? They are useful for us? No, they are harmful for us. Same thing, rat, lizards, they are also harmful for us. Rat always spread the diseases. It always cutting something and doing roaming in our house, right? They are harmful and we don't want to take them in our house. Some plants too can be harmful, as for example, dodder, pathenium and other weeds. See, plants are helpful, you know, but plants are also harmful. Which are they? See, the picture is also given, Zatula. It is very harmful plants. We don't have to touch their flowers. It is harmful for human being. Parts of natural colocasia leaves cause itching. Plants like coriander, lantana have strong odors. The datura plant is poisonous. Uncontrolled growth of fungi and algae in water, polluted drinking water may cause of diseases. Like the Here given that the plant is poisonous, I already told. Next is the plants like oriental plant have the strong odors. They are very bad. They have the very strong odors. Like the fungi also grown up into the water and they made the our water, drinking water dirty. So some plants are also very harmful for us. Now wild animals. Wild animals that hunt other animals for food are called predators. For example, tiger, lion, boars, leopards. Thus they are called the predators as they hunt the other animals and they survive on their for their food on other animals. Sometimes due to the deforestation, such animals enter human settlement in search of food and may kill domestic animals for people. See, if deforestation means humans are going to cut the trees, forests, then what the wild animals do? They are going to enter in the human settlement and they can catch the man or human also. So we don't have to deforest and we don't have to cut the trees and forests. These all characters now I explain in this lesson. I hope you understood this very well.